You just read Sexist Stingray. What'd you think?
I think it was amazing.
It was amazing?
Yeah.
Is it your favorite wooden coaster yet?
Yes.
You went 100 feet.
And still was terrifying.
You want to ride it again?
Yes.
All right, what is up, coaster people? Today is the first day after yesterday's fallout, the domino effect that happened. And if you don't know what I'm talking about, I'll give you guys a little catch up on that. 2 days ago, both Cedar Fair and Six Flags CEO both issued statements that they were going to up measures on sanitation and every property would resume operations slash open as scheduled. But later that evening, Disneyland California, followed by Disneyland Florida, and then shortly after Universal California and Florida, both announced closures through March. And then the following day, about 11:40 in the morning, it was like a domino effect. Six Flags Over Texas broke the ice by announcing that they were closing through March, and immediately after, it was Six Flags Fiesta Texas. Dollywood postponed their opening. Carowinds, Kings Dominion, Busch Gardens Williamsburg. Before you knew it, every single park was pretty much closed through March. As of right now, through the weekend, Wild Adventures, both fun spot locations, SeaWorld San Antonio, Kemah, Mall of America, and American Dream are all open, but almost all of those are slated to close. But with all that being said, again, this is the first day after that fallout of park operations. This is SeaWorld San Antonio's second to last day of operations, and we're just gonna go try to enjoy the day before coasters are closed for however long they may be closed. Again, I've done San Diego, Florida, and this park all before, and I still think that SeaWorld San Antonio is by far the best, both aesthetically and as far as the ride lineup goes. First ride of the day, maybe the best Morgan coaster out there. Definitely my favorite Morgan paper that I've rented. Lines were extremely short our last visit. We got 20 rides in on this and 20 rides in on Texas Stingray. We'll see what they are today. Hopefully just as short.
As you can see, like I anticipated with this virus, there are not very many people here, and it is spring break in Texas right now. So they just got done cleaning, now it's time to ride.
Yo, I thought that thing was good the first time I rode it. It is absolutely hauling today with full trains. Oh my god, every one of those airtime hills means something. It's just such strong ejector. It's so aggressive.
Corona, I feel like.
And for ride number two of the day, the new for this year, GCI.
Welcome back. We hope you enjoyed your ride with us here at Texas Stingray. We ask that you do as possible. Once seated, pull the lap bar down and ensure it's perfect.
Oh, this thing is much better than I remember it. It's really broken in. The airtime, the laterals, the pacing is incredible. This might be my new favorite GCI after this. It's about 30 degrees warmer this go around than when it was at the member preview, so that might have a lot to do with it too. Wait till it's 100 degrees. 100 degrees summer day. Okay, so to preface this, I've ridden every single North American GCI other than Gold Striker. After 25 rides on this last time, this was my number two behind Mystic Timbers. Now after just another 5 rides, this is my number one GCI in North America. It's only the second GCI I've ever been impressed with. I'm usually underwhelmed by them, but this and Mystic Timbers are 1 and 2.
About 2 more hours before Kemah, so we're gonna get a little more slam time in, maybe 3-4 more rides. Gotta go back row. Oh, and it is really dead up here now. All right, time for a few more on Texas Stingray before we head to Kemah. You ready, Boogie? One, no, maybe two.
I can't believe it! Real shark fish!
Really is my favorite SeaWorld park. Just such a good collection, especially their 1-2. Texas Stingray is so much better than I expected, especially with a 46-inch height limit. And then Steel Eel is by far the best Morgan coaster I've ridden. Not by far, actually, because Phantom's Revenge exists, but it's definitely my favorite. All right, and that's a wrap from SeaWorld San Antonio, but not for the day as we're heading to Kemah Boardwalk. We got over 10 rides in on Steel Eel, and Bean even got to ride over 10 rides with us on Texas Stingray. Overall, really good and therapeutic start to our day, just to get away from this whole coronavirus nonsense. Like I said, staff did a really good job at sanitizing all the rides. It's really not as bad as people are making it out to be. Until we get to Kemah, ride on.